I'm here in my Mazda 2, and this is the factory stereo system, and you'll notice there's a button on it that says text. Now, unfortunately, this does not support RDS, the radio data system. The European version of this radio does support RDS, and I believe it even has an additional button dedicated to RDS, but this one does not. So I'm tuned to an FM station that I know is broadcasting RDS, but as you can see, pushing the button does nothing. This button has two purposes. One is for playing CDs that have been recorded with MP3 or WMA audio files on them. And in that case, when you push the button, it'll show you the artist and title information of the currently playing song. And also, it supports CD text. Now, CD text is not very widely known or used. It was introduced by Sony in 1996, and I believe it's supported by Windows Media Player 10 or higher, and also VLC Media Player supports it. And it is a way to get text onto a CD to indicate things like the artist and title and album title. And it's one of the things I wondered, why was this not more widely used? Because as anybody who's ripped the CD into a computer knows, you either have to type in this information yourself or you have to rely on the CDDB database, which is also typed in by people voluntarily and thus often contains mistakes and omissions. So that is not a foolproof system, and it doesn't even list every CD, so quite a few times I have to type it in myself manually anyway. But here is a CD that was encoded using CD text, and it is a Sony product. You can see this CD was also encoded using HD CD, which is a subject worthy of its own video, which I'll get to eventually. I don't know of any car stereos that support HD CD, because in a car environment with the amount of background noise, you wouldn't be able to really take advantage of any of its benefits anyway. But nonetheless, I'll stick into CD and you'll see what it does. Starts playing the CD. And in a second here, you'll see the track information come up. Now, this is kind of a primitive system because you have to scroll it manually. You can see a button here that says scroll. So it's not like one of the more fancy displays where it would start scrolling automatically. You have to do it manually. And there's also album, wide open spaces, which is printed all uppercase for some reason. And artist, Dixie Chicks. And you can get back to the normal display for CDs. So I can go to the next track. And for some reason, it takes a couple seconds to display after you start playing the track. I don't know if that's just the way this radio does it, or if that's because of the data encoding on the CD takes that long to read. I'm not sure. But it does have all the tracks listed correctly, which would be a great help for ripping this into a computer if it was more widely used. You can see this radio's text display is kind of crude, in that you can see that the G is pushed up because it doesn't have room for the descender. And another thing I don't like about this radio is that the zeros have slashes through them. On a computer, that's understandable because you need to distinguish between a zero and the letter O. But in this case, there's no point to it. I mean, it's just going to be obvious that it's a zero. And so they really don't need to put that slash through the zero. Anyway, I have another CD here by Sony, a couple years newer. So I'm going to try that. I looked online to try to find a listing of CDs that were encoded using CD text. I did not find that. All I could find is a couple of forum posts of people mentioning a couple CDs they had in their collection, which was encoded with CD text, and someone mentioned Dixie Chicks. So I gave them a try, and indeed, that CD, it does use CD text. This one is also by Sony. a couple years newer. It says copyright 1999 Sony. So let's see if this one is also encoded using CD text. Just pop it into the player. This one was not encoded using HD CD, if that makes any difference. So we shall see. Ah, there it is. It's kind of cool. Album. It's self-titled album. Artist, same thing. There's his one big hit. Come on, here it goes. This was his follow-up song, which did not become a hit, If You Sleep. Kind of like it anyway. Sounds like a Rhodes electric piano. Maybe World, sir. It's a softer sound than the typical Wurlitzer sound, so it's hard to tell. At the drop of a tear, I can turn right away. They even put the parentheses part of it in there. And all the heartaches I've seen. So that is CD text, as supported by the stereo in my 2011 Mazda 2. Kind of an unexpected feature, and but otherwise not very widely used. Mostly, I guess, because it was a Sony technology, and as typical for the things they invent, all the way going back to Betamax and stuff like that, it's just not widely used by other companies. So, and I've never seen anywhere on a CD in the liner notes or on a CD itself, even on these, that says it was encoded using CD text. So, I don't know why they never promoted it. You would think that since Sony invented it, they would be plastering it all over their CDs, and at least it would give it a little symbol like HD CD. But it's, for some reason, they never did. And I just have to correct myself a little bit here because I'm on Sony's own website and they claim that CD text was actually developed by Philips. So it was not necessarily invented by Sony, although they were the only one who ever used it widely. I found this website that says virtually every Sony title released since April 97 has been encoded with CD text. They just haven't been advertising it.